nossa colega de Ghana.
Notre collègue du Ghana.
Well, thank you very much. I do not have very much to say in response to what has been said on the floor. I just like to say I'm very happy to be here, Mr. Director General, because the people here are involved in the process.
Sont impliqués dans ce
processus. And it is important that we do not let the process consume us to a point where, therefore, the substance is lost. This is just a caution from an old international civil servant. And I would, because of this, underline very much the need to always keep an eye on what is implemented. So I like what Peter said in the end, that truly there should be a close link in with action plans to make sure that these are not just going to be fine words on paper. The second point I want to make, however, Mr. Director General, is of a congratulatory nature. From where migration was at the time of the fashioning of the MDGs to where it is now, there is like day and night. Now, it's not an agenda item which can be ignored. The facts are too clear. For many African countries, the remittances are even more than ODA. And therefore, the impact on our countries are such that it is in our interest to ensure that the topic is captured in a manner that, at the end of the day, we will have an international environment which will enable actualization of what is of concern to us in this regard. So I think I want to congratulate you and then move on to underline the importance, therefore, of advocacy and the need for the IOM to continue to push. I mean, sometimes because of the nature of the topic, it looks like everybody should know or understand. But that's not the situation. You have to say it and say it and say it, because there are so many topics which are also asking for attention. If I look at the areas which are now trying to link in with issues of poverty alleviation, etc., I see that we really have to push for migration to be considered as an important tool in this particular agenda area. Finally, I want to say that because of the role the media has played in drawing attention to the negative aspects of migration, the task has also been made slightly easier, because the images have been so graphic and so on that maybe it's not going to be as difficult as we imagine. The thing, as I said before, is to have champions, especially at the national level. And for those ministries who are themselves involved in issues of migration, to be made an integral process, an integral part of the process of negotiation, and not to just leave it to foreign service officers. You see, these are the reasons why sometimes the conclusions cannot be implemented, because the people who are going to be involved in actually carrying it forward have not been part of the process. And maybe because of that also, what is included in these recommendations, resolutions, etc., would not be things which are relevant. So, this is all I have to say at this point. Thanks so much for bringing me in as an outsider, not involved in the process, and therefore bring talking different from trying to see what is being done. Okay. Thank you so much.
Any final words?
Yes, thank you very much. I
I don't really have a very long conclusion or answer to what has been said, and maybe I'm also like, I'd just like to repeat what was said by Peter Sutherland, that now is the moment, and because we are convinced here in this room about the importance of including migration into the post-2015 development agenda, the battle is not yet won, and I think that is a really, really important message. Good coordination between capitals, Geneva and New York, for the coming negotiations 2015 up until the next General Assembly is extremely important. I also think that what was said by my fellow panelist here, Madame Chenery Hesse, to not reach for too many entries. I think that that's also very intelligent and good strategy, to focus on what is really important. I would also like to highlight what was said about developing an African Union position, and also say that also the European Union is developing a position on this issue where migration is included, and I would here like to congratulate my Italian colleagues for working extremely well with how migration can be included in development policy, really making stellar progress within the UN, the EU. Sorry. Just to say that my own preference and suggestion would be to go very clearly for including migration into the means of implementation and look at a global partnership in the area of migration. I think that is a really important part of where we could make progress. Sorry for being very operational.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think I would like to close with more or less optimistic remarks with regard to the post-2015 agenda and the role migration has to play in that agenda. I really see it as an opportunity also for policymaking within context, because the main implementation sphere will be the national context. So some remarks came up with this implementation aspect, and Sierra Leone, for instance, or the Netherlands mentioned how this whole policy agenda to be defined at global level will translate to the national level or even the local level. I think we're not there yet, of course, and the discussion at the global level is still ongoing in New York and Geneva, of course, on defining this new goal framework also at the target level. The colleague from Mexico and Germany both mentioned targets, to concretize targets, how important this is. And I think that's exactly the work that we have to finish now at the policy level, globally. And Germany names specific targets, for instance, which are quite concretely defined and are implementable or operationalizable, if we can say it this way. So concrete targets, and we have to make sure that they remain in the document and also in the outcome document of the post-2015 agenda. So this means that we also have to keep advocating for integrating all important aspects of migration for development in this new agenda. And then the work starts at the national level. I think all countries are asked to define their national strategies on implementing the new sustainable development goals. And there we have to make sure that migration remains a priority in these national strategies. And that's why I call the whole agenda process also an opportunity, because at this level, the development planning starts, as the colleague from the Netherlands mentioned. So here we can build on the momentum that is still there at the global level, and which has to be translated to the national level. And since this agenda is a universal agenda, it also counts to countries such as my own country. And we have a big debate on how we implement the SDGs at national level right now. It has started right now in Switzerland, and we are working on renewal of the existing, already existing strategy for sustainable development at national level. So we have to get prepared for this discussion already now, but I think we have to finish the work at the global level first. And I would also like to come back to what Peter Sutherland said
at
the end, that the consensus has to be part of an action plan. I think that's really the message to take forward. And here, IOM and many other actors, non-state actors, state actors, can facilitate this process and this translation to national context. And I'm very happy that you keep on pushing and that the alliance for integrating the most important aspects of migration for sustainable development seems still to be growing.
I want to prolong this just a few minutes more, simply because I think it's important. Turkey has asked for the floor, and as the new chair of the 8th Global Forum on Migration Development, I'd like to give them the floor for just a moment. Turkey, please, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Mr. DG. I will be very brief due to the time restraint. As the chair of GFMD, we would like to reiterate the importance we attach to the inclusion of migration in the post-2015 development agenda, and we are determined to keep the momentum to this end provided by our Swedish colleagues during their chairmanship. And the 8th Forum in Istanbul next year will also consider how to insert migration into the implementation plans for SDGs, and we also stated our determination in our concept note. We look forward to working with all the concerned and interested parties as well as IOM. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And one final word, picking up on Peter Sutherland's last counsel, that it's important that member states express the same consensus in New York that is reflected here in Geneva, or it won't work. But vigilance is the word. Please join me in giving a round of applause to our distinguished panelists. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's good to see you again. I knew you'd been deputy.